big way. For example, an email and an SMS alert, which Srikanth will explain in his presentation, but I'll just briefly touch upon. Imagine that when a sales invoice is made, automatically an email and an SMS alert goes to your customer saying material dispatched, wide lorry number so and so, invoice number so and so, dated so and so. He knows for sure that the material has left your premises. He need not ring up and ask you that whether my material has left. See, it has a competitive, though very small, a competitive advantage vis-a-vis your competitors. Right? Next. Next. Hold it. We put this in a jigsaw puzzle very intentionally. At the center of everything is the BOM, that's the bill of material. That's the pivot of the ERP. Everything evolves around that. Okay, so you have the production. Ha, ye light off kar do yaar. Just switch off these lights. Can you all hear me? Are you all able to see clearly? Light off kar denge. If you have any problems, let me know. नहीं, इसको लाइट को बंद कर देते हैं ना, ऊपर का स्क्रीन को नीचे लेना. मटेरियल इज एट द सेंटर एंड ऑल द अदर मॉड्यूल्स इवॉल्व अराउंड दैट. वी हैव द प्रोडक्शन मॉड्यूल, द कॉस्ट शीट मॉड्यूल, सब कॉन्ट्रैक्टर आउट. ईच मॉड्यूल वी विल डिस्कस इन ग्रेटेस्ट डिटेल. इन्वेंट्री मैनेजमेंट, इम्पोर्ट्स, एक्सपोर्ट्स, सब कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग आउट. हाँ, दैट्स फाइन, दैट्स ओके. Okay, I want to be, this audience to be a little participative. Tell me please, why have I left those four blank? Of course, it's not blank, something is there in it. Theek hai. Somebody can help me? Why is it left blank? What, I mean, it's not blank, something is there, some modules are there. What could that be? Anji? Question marks. No, it's not filled with question marks. Don't worry. People is one. Yes, you're right. Without people, how do you run an organization? अभी तो एक ही आंसर मिला है, तीन बाकी है और. Machinery, equipment. Okay, but it's already there. You know, you can't produce without machinery. That is. People and resources the same, okay. Raw material, okay. Inventory, purchases, HR, he said human resources, he has said HR, right. All of you all have left a very key aspect. Any business starts with money and ends with money. Where is the money? That is human resources. Next. Accounts, finance, you know, it's all about money. So accounts is fully integrated from day one. The beauty of the system is that 70% to 80% of your accounts postings are automatic. And how they are automatic, I'll explain. Okay, so what is left is the balance 15-20%. That is your daily other purchases, other than for your manufacturing or anything. Say some Xerox paper or some small hardware you bought, which does not have an inventory effect, and so on and so forth. Some of your travels and so on and so forth. Even payroll is integrated with accounts. So almost 80% is integrated with accounts. Okay. When I say integrated with accounts, what do I mean? To the accounts, absolutely right. Right. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Yes. Yeah. So the GL posting takes place automatically. I'll give you another example to drive home the point. See, in a typical legacy system, which means an organization which is not using an ERP, what do they do? Say, for example, I am buying a pen. Okay? When I buy a pen, I raise a purchase order. I'm using a pen as a material in my company, okay? That's why I'm taking an example of a pen. Or you can take any product. If I'm buying a product, I raise a purchase order on my supplier, right? My supplier supplies that material to me, okay? I have given certain details in my purchase order that the material that you are going to supply to me needs to have these specifications, okay? This is the quantity I want and this is the rate. These are the three important parameters laid down in the purchase order. Okay. Okay. So once the purchase or the supplier delivers to me, I do what is called as a GRN. GRN is a goods receipt note. Yeah. So the stores person has to check whether what I have ordered is come, what the quantity I have ordered is come, and in the bill, the rate that was decided, which is there in the parent document, which is the PO, is defaulted in the invoice also, which is supplied by the supplier. Okay, my PO, he says, I have received 50 quantity. If I have ordered for 50 quantity, he says, I've got 50 quantity and clicks on the save button. Okay, the storekeeper does not have any option to alter. Okay, we will handle a situation where it does not conform to the purchase order. I'm taking a very simple example. If it conforms to the purchase order, how it is handled. So when he clicks on the save button, three effects take place automatically. What are they? One, my inventory goes up. Two, the vendor's ledger in my books of accounts gets posted, which means I have to pay him X amount. And three, whatever related taxes are there, like Mr. Janakiraman is saying, we have a plethora of taxes in our country. Whatever taxes are there, they get posted in the respective ledgers automatically. It's a question of time, Jaswinder Singh. Or kya hai? Typical in Indian conditions, these things are bound to happen. Material urgently chahiye, bhej diya usne DC or sales invoice baad mein bhejta hai. Ye to hota hai. So we have given a provision whereby you can open that and enter the actual date of the invoice received from the supplier on a subsequent date. But mind you, till then you cannot pass the bill. Obviously, unless he gives you an invoice, you can't pass the bill. Right?
That's why. Stocks?
Stock will go up because you have done the GRN. You have taken the material inside. There is no problem because aapka activity ruk nahi sakta. See, the idea is an ERP is got to be a facilitator. It cannot become an impediment in your working. It should not become an hindrance. Right? तो वो रिजिडिटी नहीं है. कहने का मतलब है कि शुरुआत में सब खोल देंगे, आप करो जैसा करना है करो. धीरे 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 ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स ऑफ द इंप्लीमेंटेशन एंड वंस द यूजर्स ऑल्सो गेट यूज टू यू ऑल्सो अप्राइज योर वेंडर्स, यू ऑल्सो अप्राइज योर कस्टमर्स, देन वी विल पुट द लॉक्स कि इसके बिगर ये नहीं होगा. Can Tata Motors accept your material without an invoice? Please tell me. Can you send it on challan to Tata Motors? You can't, no? So you tell your supplier that I am supplying to Tata Motors. I need to raise an invoice on him. You want your payment? You send your material with the invoice. Purchase order is a passive document. I want to explain to each one of you all here the difference between a passive document and an active document in ERP. What a passive document means is that it has no accounting and inventory effect. An active document is one which has an inventory and accounting effect. So, yeah, like I said, it captures the end-to-end business cycle, any type of organization, be it manufacturing, be it retailing or even wholesale. Next. typically